I'm Lynn with Psychic Focus of psychicfocus.blogspot.com, and today's post is about angels, and the topic is angels among us. And I love this question. And what they wrote to me was, it's been said that angels take many forms. The Bible says something about entertaining strangers because they might be angels and we won't know it. How often do we pass an angel while we're walking down the street or standing in a crowd? If they are present, are they observing? Are they waiting to see if we offer them kindness? And does it happen very often? Or is this extremely rare? Thanks. And again, I just love this question. I thought it was such a beautiful question. And when I focused on this, I got that angels work through people. I didn't necessarily see them in a physical form, but they guide people and influence people to do their work. And we encounter these touched souls all the time, in the street, in stores, in crowds, you name it. These touch souls are always around us. And when you encounter a person that, you know, we all meet these people, they're just extra, just happy and loving and generous. And you feel their energy. You want to be in their presence. And I get that these angels, a lot of times these people have an angel's presence tied to them. That is why they exhibit that type of emotion. And it could be that maybe that person wasn't always like that. And somehow this angelic being came into their life. Maybe they needed it. Maybe they prayed for it. Who knows what? But regardless, at that point in time, when these angels are there and they're tied to them, they just have that energy about them. The angel doesn't control them, but it does give them this love and support that they need that allows their vibration to be so high. And that love and support, basically it shines through the person and we see it and we feel it. I also got that angels, they don't test us to see what we're going to do. In fact, they work in the greater good and hope to set an example for us to be better people. And they exude energy in hope that we follow suit. There's no punishment for not being kind. However, there's a great personal reward in being nice. Your experience is your experience. They don't tell us what to do. They don't force us. They don't test us. They don't try to trick us and see how we're going to respond. But the end result is your experience creates your experience. You make it positive, you can make it negative, or you can be indifferent. But the feelings that you achieve, they're your own doing, your own feelings. So be mindful in your actions, be mindful in what's going on around you, and just think. Try to give it some forethought. Think about how you want to live your life, how you want to feel, how do you want to be viewed, and you know, are you putting positivity out there? I mean, it's really your life to determine how you want to experience and how you want to be felt by others. And that was really all I had for this reading, but again, I just thought it was such a beautiful question. And I just want to put a shout out to all of you. Thank you, everybody that reads the blog, who's subscribed and passed the word and everything else. And thank you to all you patrons out there. I couldn't do it without you. So just a quick shout out and a thanks. And again, I'm Lynn with Psychic Focus at psychicfocus.blogspot.com. Thank you. Bye.